Rustox. Rustox is one of the leading homeopathic medicine in our homeopathic Matra Medica. The restlessness is the PQRS unique symptom of homeopathic medicine Rustox, which is very helpful in selection of medicine for prescription of our patient. So friends, hello and welcome to our channel Homeopathy, the Healing Power. And today we are going to study homeopathic medicine Rustox. But before that, subscribe the channel, press the bell icon so that you will be get notified whenever a new video is uploaded from Homeopathy, the Healing Power. Like this video and share this video, as we are going to share with you the detailed keynotes and constitution of Rustox, which will help you to identify the restlessness and typical symptoms of Rustox, which will help the students to write Rustox in their Matra Medica exams and help the practitioners to prescribe Rustox in their clinics. So friends, let's get started. Rusk toxicodendron, where rusk means red and toxicodendron means poisonous plant. Well friends, in similar way, the flowers and the leaves of Rustox plants are red in color, and the Rustox plant is itself a poisonous plant. So the common name of this medicine is poison oak, and it belongs to the family Anacardiaceae. This medicine is proved by Dr. Samuel Hahnemann sir. Dr. Samuel Hahnemann sir introduced Rustox in his homeopathic practice in the year 1816. The most important active principle of Rustox is toxicodendric acid. Toxicodendric acid is a fixed oil volatile substance. This acid is given by the plant in greatest amount when sun goes down, that is nothing but in sunset. In damp cloudy weather and in warm days of month of June and July. Friends, this is nothing but the beauty of our nature. But the most important part to be noted here is how our pathy, homeopathy, is synchronized with this nature. And that we can see through the symptomatology of Rustox. Now let's see here friends. The symptoms of Rustox also gets aggravated at night, that is nothing but when sun goes down. Also in damp cloudy weather. In fact, most of the symptoms of Rustox originates from cloudy air, and this times is seen in month of June and July. So friends, starting from the word meaning itself till now, whatever we have studied is nothing but the doctrine of signature in our homeopathy. And this most important point will be helpful as an practitioners to prescribe Rustox in our clinic and as a student to remember Rustox for their exams. Now friends, let's see the sphere of action of Rustox. Friends, Rustox specially acts upon joints, and in joints it also has some special action on ligaments, fibrous tissues and on tendons of joint. Along with that, Rustox also shows its special action upon mucous membrane, lymphatic glands, skin and muscular tissues. Now friends, let's see the pathogenesis of Rustox. Friends, as we have seen in the sphere of action itself, Rustox has its special action on joints. So, by acting on cellular tissues, first of all, Rustox produces inflammation and infiltration. Here, inflammation is seen in all parts of the body. For example, in glands, on cells, on serous membrane, anywhere. First of all, Rustox produces inflammation and infiltration. The process of inflammation is not up to here. In Rustox, this inflammation easily converts or easily transforms into pus formation. The affected part looks shiny with dark and red color. Here in Rustox, there is also one typical look of swelling, which differentiates Rustox swelling from other medicines like Belladonna and Apis. And this swelling is like the affected part, which is shiny red in color, also has skin complaints over the swelling, and these skin complaints are described as numerous small painful white vesicles over the inflammatory area. Rustox also has its action on glands of our body, among which axillary gland and parotid gland are the special seat of action. Here, Rustox also produces inflammation, induration, and later pus formation. By acting on circulatory system, Rustox produces febrile disturbances, typhoid-like symptoms, and different types of fevers like intermittent fever. Rustox also has its remarkable action on skin, and here it produces rheumatoid inflammation, eruptions, burning sensation, and itching sensation over skin. Rustox produces all types of skin complaints like ulcers, corns, impetigo, acne rosacea, milk crust, herpes zoster, warts, chaps, chilblains, and many more. Friends, this is the pathogenesis of Rustox. Because of its special action on joints and special inflammation which is seen on joints and other part of the body, Rustox has rheumatoid and gouty diathesis. Constitutionally, Rustox is suited to very chilly persons, patients who are very susceptible to cold and cold air, that even a single draught of cold air aggravates or brings on their complaints. Relation with heat and cold. Rustox patients are very chilly. Even open air is intolerable to Rustox patient. Friends, now let's see how symptoms originates in Rustox. In Rustox, symptoms are originated due to exposure to cold, by getting wet in rain, by wetting the head, by overstraining or overexertion, by overlifting or raising the arm high to lift things, by bruises, by getting wet in rain while overheated or sweating, and by anger. Friends, all of these reasons originates the symptoms in Rustox patient. Friends, there are three most important keynote of Rustox. These are the most important and unique differentiating symptoms of Rustox, which differentiates the Rustox from other medicines. Friends, most of you ask us in comments section that what are those important symptoms that we must keep in our mind while prescribing a medicine to patient. Friends, these are the most important symptoms which we are going to discuss now in Rustox. And they are: number 1, the unique modality of Rustox, and that is amelioration by continuous motion. Friends, this modality runs in Rustox from starting to the end.
Oh, I am feeling pain in my back. I am feeling hardness and stiffness in my back. Let me move about for some time. I may feel better. I now feel better after continuous walking.
Whatever may be the clinical condition, whether it may be rheumatism, headache, diarrhea, dysentery, or any condition, amelioration by continuous motion is seen in Rustox. The second most important keynote of Rustox is great sensitive to exposure to cold air. All the complaints of Rustox gets started by exposure to cold air, and patient is very much sensitive to cold air and to all atmospheric changes.
It's raining outside. This cold air. If I get exposed in this cold air, then my knee pain will start.
Patient is so much sensitive to cold air that even when the sky becomes cloudy, patient puts on the warm clothes on himself as an act of precaution. This sensitiveness to cold is so extreme that even when a single part of the body is exposed to cold air, the symptoms get started. The troubles get started in Rostock's patient, or it aggravates the trouble of Rostock's patient. But when patient gets wet in rain, this condition brings the extreme level of troubles in Rostock's patient. The third and most important keynote of Rostock's is restlessness. Here, restlessness is seen in Rostock's patient because continuous motion ameliorates the condition. So, patient continuously moves here and there. Also, restlessness is seen because of anxiety, apprehension, and uneasy feeling. Patient moves here and there to obtain a relief. But this restlessness causes muscular weakness and exhaustion at the end. And again, this muscular weakness and exhaustion produces the symptoms in Rostock's patient. In this way, at the end, patient finds no relief from his complaints, and patient never finds ease and rest. Now friends, let's see in which clinical conditions we can prescribe Rostock's. Friends, wherever there is a symptom similarity, Rostock's can be prescribed. But still, there are some clinical conditions in which Rostock's acts wonderfully. So, we will be seeing these clinical conditions one by one. Rostock's in rheumatism. Rostock's is very useful medicine in rheumatism, also because Rostock's has rheumatoid and gouty diathesis. And as we have seen in sphere of action and pathogenesis itself, Rostock's has its special action on joints. Rheumatism in Rostock's is caused due to lying on damp ground, by getting wet in rain, or by handling clay. Especially the right side is affected, so the joints of right sides gets more affected here. Right-sided joints are swollen with severe pain. While pain, the patient suffers through very typical sensation, and this sensation is described as pain as if sprained, as if a muscle or tendon were torn from its attachment. Pain as if the bone were scraped with knife. The affected parts are very sore to touch. During pain, patient is very much restless, anxious, and in very fearful state. So patient moves on continuously to obtain relief. Complaints get aggravated after midnight. First motion or moving first time at morning out of the bed aggravates the stiffness and lameness in patient, but continuous motion then ameliorates the joint pain. There is also a typical concomitant symptom seen in Rostock's during rheumatism, and that is, along with rheumatism, there may be fever or heart diseases. Backache is also one of the most important condition where Rostock's can prescribed, and it acts very well. Here again, backache is caused due to cold air exposure or by straining. Backache is specially seen in between the shoulders. There is great pain and stiffness. And there is a very typical symptom seen, friends, and that is, there is a pain on swallowing. Backache gets aggravated by sitting or lying down, and it gets ameliorated by motion or lying on something hard. Friends, now let's see Rostock's in fever. Rostock's is indicated in fever. In all types of fever, like remnant fever, intermittent fever, continuous fever, or even in typhoidal fever. Friends, let's see the series of events which takes place in fever. Fever in Rostock's starts due to bathing in rain or in ponds, in streams, or living in damp room. Yawning and stretching are the first symptoms seen. Patient feels very much weak and loss of energy. Along with that, here body pain, or we can say body ache, also starts. Along with all these symptoms, dry, teasing, fatigue, cough also starts. And friends, All these symptoms are nothing but the prodromal stage of fever. Then next comes the chill stage. In this stage, all the symptoms of prodromal stage gets intensified. The stretching becomes more violent. The yawning is also very louder, and patient suffers from very distressing pain in limbs. The chill generally starts in evening. Patient shivers with great chilliness. Patient feels as if he is being washed with ice cold water. At this moment, a least movement like eating or drinking aggravates the chill. But still patient moves on here and there to obtain relief from joint pain. The cough that we have seen in the prodromal stage is still present here. The chill is now followed by the real febrile stage, that is nothing but the heat stage. Here, at this stage, there is a rise in body temperature. Along with that, there is a headache present. The teasing cough which we have seen in prodromal stage and in the chill stage now passes off in the heat stage, and in that place, urticaria is seen. Urticaria breaks out all over the body with violent itching and with great thirst. Patient is very much thirsty at this stage. Patient is restless at this stage. Patient continuously changes the position, but he finds no rest. After this stage, there is a profuse odorless perspiration seen, and the fever goes down. Along with that, the urticaria which we have seen in the heat stage also passes off after the perspiration. Rustox is also indicated in typhoidal fever, and whenever there is a typhoidal fever, a mild delirium is also seen. During delirium, patient jumps out of the bed and escapes. Patient is very much restless. Patient constantly changes his positions. Sometimes he lies on back, next moment on the sides. In this way, constantly he changes his position. Mild hallucination is also seen. Patient suspects that everyone is conspiring against his life, and so he would not take any medicine or food from attendants for the fear that they will poison him or kill him. During interrogation, patient will answer the questions very slowly and reluctantly. The delirium ends in stupor. Stupor is nothing but reduce in consciousness. And at this stage, there is a great apathy, indifference seen. Patient passes involuntary stool and urination in this stage. Some typical dreams are also seen in Rustox patient, and these are: patient dreams of great exertion. Patient dreams that he is roaming over field, climbing hills, swimming in tank, walking through snow. During fever, a very typical type of tongue is seen in Rustox patient, and that is the tongue is broad and flabby with impressions of teeth, while other times the tongue is dry, rough with red triangular tip. After fever, paresis or paralytic condition of a single muscle or single part of body is seen. Rustox is also indicated in paralysis. Also, not only after fever, but in Rustox, paralysis is also seen after getting feet wet, on lying on damp ground, after exertion, after parturition. Here, paralysis is seen of any single part of the body, especially the extremities and the eyelids. There is a numbness of affected part with paresis of limbs and ptosis. Now let's see the mind of Rustox patient. Rustox is very anxious patient. Anxiety is a keynote of Rustox, and this anxiety brings on the mental symptoms of Rustox. The severe body pain brings on anxiety in Rustox patient. Patient is very much restless and apprehensive. He feels that he has come to the limit of his endurance. Now he cannot handle any type of pain in his limbs and in his body. So now thoughts of suicide come on his mind. There is a great disgust for life. Patient weeps with great despondency. Patient find himself very helpless. And now comes restlessness. Along with that, typical type of dream and delirium is also seen. Friends, which we have already discussed earlier. Rustrox is also a most important medicine indicated in vesicular eruptions of skin. Rustrox is indicated in almost all types of skin diseases like erysipelas, acne rosacea, impetigo and many more. The skin complaints come from left to right with much swelling, inflammation, burning, itching and stinging pain. These complaints get worse at night in cold, wet, rainy weather and gets ameliorated in dry weather and by warm application. Relations with other medicine. Rustrox is complementary to Bryonia and inimical to Apis. So friends, this is the detailed video on Rustrox. Please leave your valuable feedback and any suggestions in the comments section given below. Like this video, share this video, subscribe the channel. Meet you soon. Thank you for watching.